The money was a boon, there was no doubt about that. But it was blood money, and I couldn't believe God would work that way.
I don't like it. Not one bit. Why, Jack? Why me? Why now?
They say God helps those who help themselves. And I had done absolutely nothing to get this money. I didn't trust it. Suddenly, the cantor's words came back to me.
A Shivah call. I can't just barge in unannounced, but I can pay a Shivah call. It's the only way.
Alright. I wanna check for Lauder. But he's not a Jew, so... Oh wait, I have to log in. Ugh, crap, what's the... Damn it, you... I forgot the word. No worries, guys, I'm gonna write this down right now. Yenta! I do not know Yenta. An R stone I had no trouble remembering, but I wrote it down anyway. So. Search. Contact info. 100 Jane Street. I'm gonna write it down. Jane Street, apartment 4E, and Garment District Murder. Jack Lauder of Beth Tikva was found dead last night in his Midtown office, victim of an apparent assault by a person or persons unknown. We at Ravnet express our sympathies to Jack's friends and family. Cantor. No, okay, I'm gonna log out then. Any more mail, actually. These are all the same. Oh, wait. There's arrows. Oh, we got more? Okay. From Tomo, an undisclosed email. Special offer. For your network protection needs, contact Tomo. Okay. From manager at electric.com. Final notice. Due to continuing non-payment, your electrical service will be terminated if the overdue balance of $525.67 is not met by April 21st. Contact our office if you have any questions. From Sapple at Vaco.net, disappointed. Rabbi Stone, I have tried to have faith in you, but it's obvious that you are becoming increasingly more unbalanced. You call yourself a Jew? Our people need leaders. Regretfully, Sarah Applebaum. Applebaum. From Don. Oh, we've got a Don at thebankofnewyork.com. Overdraft notice. This is to inform you that your account is currently $1,893.43 into its overdraft. As you're aware, your account only has $1,000 of overdraft protection. Please submit the difference of $893.43 to us within 7 days so as not to damage your credit rating. Now, these people who sent us this stuff, we don't find entries, yeah. As we don't need to be looking them up. Okay, so I have his info. Now I can climb into the crawl space, baby. The records are cleared out every few years. If I wanted information about Jack Lauder, I'd have to look elsewhere. Oh, well, I did look elsewhere. Okay, I see no reason to hang around here. I can finally look at stuff in this room. Rabbi's lectern. A sturdy, dependable podium, perfect for pounding during less successful sermons. There was nothing on the podium. This cabinet was converted into a makeshift Torah Ark after the last one was stolen in 1996. The Torah Ark was locked up tight. Besides, I didn't want to tempt any vandals in the area. Cantor's Lectern. The Cantor's Lectern contained his prayer book and song notations. I had no need for the Cantor's things. You can't look at things at the top of the screen, obviously. There's a hole in the wall there. There's seats. There's candles. Okay. We're done. Manhattan Isle. There's a Lauder residence. Now, I'm guessing this would not appear if we hadn't looked up the info in the computer.
Mrs. Hello? Lauder?
Yes?
I heard about your husband. I came to pay my respects.
Oh, you knew Jack?
Why would I come here and give her an evasive response, honest response?
Some time ago, yes.
All right, come on in.
Well, thank you. I didn't have to knock 3,000 times like that.
I'm sorry, you look so familiar, but I can't place your face.
Cantor.
What is your name?
If I wanted answers, she'd have to know who I was. Well, obviously. This required tact. Well, give her the honest response.
My name is Rabbi Russell Stone. Your husband used to be a member of my congregation.
Oh, I remember now. You have a lot of nerve coming here.
Oops. What did I do? Apologize?
Well, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, you're sorry, are you?
What did I do?
I'm so glad to hear that. Jack would love to hear that you are sorry.
He knows already, Mrs. Lauder.
Too late, Rabbi. Too late.
The hell did
what
I do?
What do you want?
Definitely not the middle one. The rabbinical approach? Other options haven't fared as so well for me, so I think I'll try this one.
Do I need to have a reason to pay a Shivah call?
Huh, if it's you, yes.
She's pissed.
Stop it. Just stop it. I don't believe this. You threw us out of your temple 8 years ago.
I did?
And now you drop by for a visit?
It wasn't like that.
Well, what was it then? Can you tell me that?
I hope so.
Maybe this was a bad idea.
Maybe you're right. And yet, you're here. Why?
I have no idea. Rabbinical or direct? Direct approach. She really wants to know, so let's tell her. I'd like to know myself.
The police visited me today.
Well, that's true, but what did we do? Why
did
we...
they?
Yes.
Why did we kick him out?
What did they say?
That I'm suspect number one.
Really? Well, that would make sense. Who else has a motive except for the rabbi who hates us?
Accepting? Do I hate them? I don't know what the background is here. Why did I kick them out, or supposedly kick them out? Rabbinical approach, I guess.
Why do you think I hate you, Mrs. Lauder?
Enough! Do you have to do that here? Now? There is a time and a place, Rabbi.
Okay.
And this is not it.
Look, I don't hate...
Whatever. Jack hated you. That's enough.
Mrs. Lauder, if he hated me so much, why did he leave me $10,000 in his will?
Ba-bum!
That's impossible!
I said the same thing.
But yet...
Jack wouldn't do that.
It's a crazy world.
How do you know for sure?
The police told me. I have no love of the police, but I doubt they'd lie about that. Mrs. Lauder, if Jack hated me so much, why did he give me so much money?
I don't know. This makes no sense. None of it does. Who would kill Jack? He was a good man.
Yes, he was.
Don't you start. You have no idea.
The police have no other leads?
Aside from you? No.
How did he die?
I don't see how that's any of your business.
Well, I suppose I'm curious, and I'd like to help.
Help? Why would you want to help?
I don't know. Maybe I...
I want to make amends.
Maybe I'm looking to make amends for what happened 8 years ago.
Why not? Why shouldn't a rabbi play at being detective? You want to investigate, Rabbi Stone? Be my guest.
I'll have to ask you some questions about what happened.
Can't you just ask the police?
They won't talk to me. I'm a suspect.
Fine. Fine. Ask whatever you want.
Achievement unlocked. Heflek, remain polite and civil and something. Ask about the murder.
How did Jack die?
He was shot right in the head at close range, according to the police.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Lauder.
He was in the showroom, working late. That's all I know.
I wonder if she did it. Never know. We just need to find out a motive, right? Ask about... business? His business?
What business was your husband in?
Yeah.
We were in business together. Fashion design. High-end casual wear. Shirts, blouses, slacks. I'd design and he'd sell.
Oh my. The state of the business.
Was the business successful?
We did all right. It was tough at first, but things have been picking up over the last few years. We sell to mainly boutique stores, but Macy's has bought several pieces from us, and Saks was interested.
Location of the business.
Where is your showroom?
Why, do you want to have a look?
It can't hurt.
Oh, this is crazy. Do you really want to do this?
Yes.
Sure, if you want to have a look, go ahead. Just because trained police officers couldn't find anything doesn't mean a rabbi can't. The building is 1407 Broadway, room 903.
Just writing it down just in case. 1407 Broadway, room 903. Future of the business.
And what happens to the business now? Are you going to run it by yourself?
I guess I could, but not right away. And definitely not in that same showroom.
I can understand that.
Company name.
What is the name of your business?
Charming Fashion Company.
Charming.
Yeah, it's a strange name, but it has meaning behind it. It's based on my family's name, Sharma, and it sounds like charming.
Right.
I get it. Real cute.
Ask about a mirror?
You've covered up the mirror.
Yes. Oh, it's that? What you are supposed to do, right?
Well, yes, but...
I know. I'm not Jewish. I'm probably doing it all wrong, but it feels right. Is it right, Rabbi?
Are they not Jewish because we kicked them out, or do we kick them out because they're not Jewish? They didn't hold to the basic tenets of the Jewish faith, something like that? So... we kicked them out, and they decided, well, we're not actually Jewish after all? Comforting response. She's probably gonna think it's BS, but...
it's perfect.
Thank you.
Oh, good. State of mind.
How are you holding up, Mrs. Lauder?
Fine. As well as can be expected.
Consult your notes. Charming.
Can you tell me about your company again?
Sure. What do you want to know?
Okay. So there's nothing else, just charming. Okay. Oh, that's neat. Okay. Take my leave.
I'm going to leave now. I'll see what else I can discover.
Thanks, I guess. Rabbi Stone?
Yes?
About 8 years ago, could you just tell me why?
Yeah, I'd like to know.
Were you and Jack happy?
Yes. Yes, we were.
Then my reasons don't matter.
Huh. There's something going on between him and Jack? I have no idea. Or was Jack having an affair with somebody? Curious. Really want to know that. Most of all, I want to know that even more than finding out who killed him. Believe it or not. Alright, charming fashion, here we come. Alright. Too bad we can't use tab to, you know, select things. Hey man, nice rack. Had no need for a clothing hanger. The clothing rack was empty. I suppose Mrs. Lauder took everything away. A dressmaker's dummy. I wasn't that less desperate for a larger congregation. So this is the exit. We can't look at the light. Designs for some sort of skimpy sundress with some orders attached. They weren't relevant to my problem. This design board was the only spark of creativity left in this deserted showroom. I don't know much about fashion design, but it looked like a skirt. Or maybe a large shirt. I couldn't think of a reason to take it with me. It was a poster of some blank-faced woman in a hat. I made a snap decision not to start collecting old fashion posters. There's a computer there. I'll probably save that for last. There's a vent. There's a shelf. Paints, markers, and random junk adorn the shelf. I didn't need any of that. Photo. It was a photo of Mrs. Lauder with a post-it note reading, "Don't forget anniversary flowers." I decided to leave it where it was. Alright, so the only thing left is the computer. The office computer remained on the desk. It assumed that Mrs. Lauder... I assume that Mrs. Lauder didn't want to be bothered with it. But we will, however, be very bothered with this, won't we? Password. How are we going to know that? This will not work. We need the password. I wonder what it could be. Well, no idea then. We gotta find out what this password is. Clues. Could it be one of these? Shiksei. Maybe she's not Jewish. He married someone who wasn't Jewish. Shiksei. Didn't spell it right, did it? Ow! How do you spell that? S-H-I-K. Nope. Goy. Non-Jewish person. No, I don't know what it is then. I could just randomly try more of those, but we don't even know if it's any of those. Maybe I can go back and just ask her what the password is. Like, she's really gonna tell me that. Maybe we'll get a hint about it, though.
Mrs. Lauder.
Oh, it's you. come on in.
Yep, it's me. I had no idea, but yeah, it is me. Charming,
Can you tell me about your company again?
Sure. What do you...
What business?
We were in business fashion, high-end casual wear.
What is the...
Charming?
Charming.
Yeah, it's a stream. It's based on my family's name,
Sharma.
And it sounds...
I get it. Real cute.
Sharma or charming?
And what happens to the bu-
I guess I could, but not right away. And definitely not-
I can understand that. Was the business?
We did all right. It was tough at first. We sell to mainly boutique stores.
Alright.
I'm going to leave now. I'll see what else-
Thanks. I guess.
It would be stupid to make it Sharma or Charming. But I will try. Nope, I spelled it right, right? Let's see. Ah! Welcome back, Jack Lauder. Please choose an option below. That is a stupid password, stupidest password ever. It's her last name. Ledger. Recent transactions. Okay. $500 paid out to Joe DeMarco, personal. And to Goldberg and Weiselbaum, $200 accounting. Macy's, I got over $2,600 for the goods received. Joe DeMarco. Who's this Joe DeMarco? Look, he's giving a lot of money to this Joe DeMarco. So I am going to write him down in here. Because we might be looking him up in our computer. Back at the... whatever the hell you call that place. Synagogue? Oh. Grayson Sportswear. Lose shipping. More Joe DeMarco. Look at that. Like he's paying off a loan shark or something. Well, Beth Tikva, $200. So he's paying out loads of money to this Joe DeMarco. Basically, looking at out in, he's paying out more money than they're taking in. I mean, this was a good amount. Of course, this really helped. Mail from Ethan G. Business Matters. Jack, that must be an oversight. I'll look into it. E. Huh. From Rashtri Lauder. Rashtri Lauder? Patterns and Producers. Hello, partner. I'll get those shirt designs done. I'll send copies out to the factory to get fit samples made. And guess what? I got them. Spent an hour on the phone with Telecharge, but I got the tickets. Orchestra seats, too. I'll meet you at the office at 6. No excuses this time. Love, Raj. Oh, is that her? Her name? Her married name. From Tomo, special offer. Yeah, I've seen that. From Ethan G. Jay, this is strange. The rates do seem unusually high. I'll look into it. E. From Kenny Liu, shipping. Mr. Lauder, how are you? Your goods are packed and ready to ship. Wire us the funds and we'll get it on the next boat. Kenny. Ethan G. Helps him in some way. Business matters. And then Kenny Lou. Jay, your instinct was right. Something isn't right with this deal. All the wire transfers lead to different places, and nobody answers the phone at any of them. My accountant sense is tingling. Ethan G. Okay, is the accountant. I will write that down. Don't panic, Jack. I'll get to the bottom of this. See you at the temple tonight. From Rashri Lauder. Okay. Hello, hello. The fit model canceled again? Can she be any more useless? Okay, we'll just have to find somewhere else. Don't forget we're having dinner at the Goldwaters tonight. Love, Rash. Ethan G. Trouble. Jay, call me now. We need to talk. Ethan G. Meeting. Okay, I got you into this mess. I will get you out of it. I'm meeting with JDM tonight. Joe DeMarco? Do not write him any more checks until you hear from me. If he wants to play hardball, he picked the wrong guys to mess with. You wanna play hardball? I'm game. JDM? A rotten deal? This was worth looking into. Indeed. I have to go through this again. From Kenny Lou, money transfer? Mr. Lauder, how are you? We are still awaiting payment transfer from you. Your goods are taking up space in our warehouse. Please submit the monies ASAP or we will be forced to liquidate them. Kenny Lou is a shipper? Something like that? From Ravnet Admin. Undeliverable. The following message was undeliverable. The reported error was subscriber R. Steno. He spelled R. Stone wrong. Does not exist on Ravnet. Message is as follows. Hello, Rabbi Stone. It's been a while. I hope I got the correct email address. No doubt you are surprised to hear from me. I'm not sure why I'm writing either. I often think about what you said. It still angers me, but I can understand your motives. You looked at us and said, nothing is worse than when Jews turn their backs on one another. I can still remember that look in your eyes. Sheer contempt, like we were the worst sort of scum that ever crawled out of the ocean. I love my wife, Rabbi Stone. She's my partner in everything. I regret nothing. Nothing, that is, except you. I hated you. For years, I hated you. We both did. I joined another temple with a rabbi who was willing to marry us and tried to forget about you. But when I found myself in trouble and in need of guidance, I could think of nowhere else to turn. You called me a traitor once. Do you still feel that way? I've seen traitors. I've seen Jews turn their backs on other Jews. It's not pretty. It's awful. I am not like them. Time has cooled my hatred. Has it done the same to you? I need to speak to you. I feel like I am 12 years old again, preparing for my bar mitzvah and needing help with my Torah portion. I know I didn't marry a Jewish girl, or go to temple every week, or keep kosher, or do any of the many things we're supposed to do, but I have always have known that I was Jewish. Is that enough? I'm not a traitor, Rabbi. I have never forgotten I'm Jewish. Jack Lauder. Alright. So looks like the rabbi really took it personally that he married someone, a non-Jew, didn't keep kosher, didn't go to temple every week. Is that why? The split between them? So is this Joe DeMarco? About $500 a clip. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I wish I knew which order these went in, of like the first one is the most recent, or we're going down to more and more. If we're going more and more recent, the amount is going up by about $20-$25 every time. Because we know dates, that would be helpful. Combine clues by dragging one on top of the other. Okay, JDM, Joe DeMarco. Jack Lauder received an email from Ethan G. discussing a meeting with JDM. Jack Lauder received a few urgent emails from an Ethan G. I need to find out more about this person. Right? I thought I was dragging... Wait a second. Where are you going? Get back here. I'm trying to combine clues, damn you. Let's go back in here. Yeah, I don't know. I'm dragging him on top. Okay. Maybe we just can't do these? Alright, I'm gonna leave. Unless I'm dragging... No, I can't. Yeah, I can't move them out. It just tells us... Let's go back to the computer and look up these people.